We have reached the weekend here at the 28th Winter Universiade in Almaty. Competition continues here midway through the games. In this summary, we'll go back to Friday for curling action. On the men's side, Japan takes on unbeaten Great Britain. In hockey, the Czech Republic will take on host Kazakhstan from Halyk Arena. From today, it'll be the women's 1,000-meter speed skating from Medeu. Cross-country skiing is the mixed team sprint. And from alpine skiing, the men's giant slalom. From yesterday here in Almaty, this is the Almaty Arena. Curling action, Great Britain taking on Japan. Great Britain, with their skip Bruce Mowat, along with Bobby Lamy and Gregor Cannon, won the World Junior Curling title last year. They're 6-0 coming into this game. Japan, skipped by Kosuke Hirata, are 3-3, so they're trying to stay in the mix for playoff contention. First end, here's the last rock for Hirata. Facing a whole mess of rocks. And he'll just nudge back the British stone to lie one. But here's Mowat with his final rock of the first end. Supers do a great job. He knocks out one of his own, takes out the Japanese one, but still lies three. Great Britain up 3-0 after the opening end. Now Mowat's final stone here in the second. Simple takeout there to lie one. And now Hirata, looking to blank this end. But the stone just sticks on the edge of the 12 foot. He will score one to trail 3-1. Now moving on to the third end. Japan facing three British stones. Knocks the one back to the 12 foot. But now Mowat with an opportunity for a draw for four. And he'll do that quite easily. Now 7-1 Great Britain after three ends. On to the fourth. And there you see the takeout. Britain lying three with that last one just on the edge of the 12 foot. So Hirata needing to draw to the button. But it looks like Great Britain might steal. They'll measure. And that is exactly what happens. It's a steal of one for Britain in the fourth. They're now up 8-1. Here is the skip Mowat's final stone of the fifth. And now Hirata. He was an alternate on Team Japan in Grenada in 2015 at Universiade. And there's a nice takeout for him. Japan will score two to draw within five. Now in the sixth end. Good job there by the sweepers to bring that right to the button. But Mowat with a chance here to add a couple more to his total. And a nice takeout there. And it will be two, now 10-3 for Mowat and his rink. In the seventh, a really nice double takeout there for Great Britain. And so Hirata with open rings. Draws it just to the top of the 12-foot, and they'll shake hands there. Final ends up 10-4. Great Britain now moves to 7-0 here at the Universiade event, while Japan falls to 3-4 and has some work to do to get themselves into playoff contention. The rink of Mowat, Lamy, Cannon, Sloan, and Schreiber in control, unbeaten at Universiade. Men's hockey action winds up its preliminary round here at the Halak Arena. This is the Czech Republic against host nation Kazakhstan. Each team is 2-0 coming in, and the winner of this game will get top spot in Group A. Kazakhstan had a 22-0 win over China and then a 5-0 win over Sweden, while the Czech Republic also beat Sweden 5-0 and then knocked off the Chinese 15-0. So neither team has given up a goal so far in this tournament. There you saw the officials, and now the starting lineup for the Czech Republic. There's head coach Jaroslav Liska. And there is the lineup for Kazakhstan. And their head coach Sergei Starigin. Packed house, loud crowd here, and we're underway. There you see some of the fans looking on. It's an early chance deflected in there by Dominic Novak. This will draw a crowd and a slashing penalty, and Grebenshikov will sit down for a couple minutes as the talking continues. There you see the slash right in front. Grebenshikov gets it and then continues to push and shove a little bit, trying to draw a Czech player to the box with him. But now, later in the first period, rebound spills out there and is tipped home ultimately by Konstantin Savinkov. Dulnev and Nurek get the assists. Kazakhstan up 1-0 after the first period. Now to the second. Here's Artin Bertilev on the flip pass. Ends up on the breakaway. He'll cash in. 2-0 Kazakhstan. Now shortly after that, a really nice feed in front. And Grenz will cash in the nice pass there from Alexei Ansifarov. Quickly, it's 3-0 Kazakhstan. Now on a two-man advantage. Cross-ice pass there. Nikita Mikhailis Rister finds the twine. And Kazakhstan up by 4 early in the third. There's a centering pass. Pavel Agzelin centers it there, tipped home by Savinkov. He has 2 on the night. Then a turnover inside the Czech zone. Anton Petrov in alone. Fights off 2 checkers, and he'll cash in with the backhand. It is now 6-0 Kazakhstan. They're back on the power play here. But a penalty there also now upcoming to Filip Svaracek for the high stick on Savinkov. You'll see it right there, right to the face. And so Kazakhstan will enjoy a two-man advantage. There you see Svaracek in the box. And here's Mikhailis with the puck. Little saucer pass across the crease, and Kirill Savitsky fires it home. 7-0 for the Kazakhs. And there's a really nice feed to the front of the net. And Bertilev with a nice finish for his second off that nice pass from Nurek. That would be it. 8-0. Kazakhstan wins easily. Savinkov, 2 goals, 1 assist, now tied for the tournament scoring lead with 9 points. Bertilev also with 2 goals. He leads all goal scorers in the tournament. Kazakhstan finishes atop Group A at 3-0, while the Czech Republic ends up second at 2-1. Beautiful aerial shot there of the Medeu Sports Complex in Almaty. The sun poking through the clouds here a little bit on what has been a relatively foggy week at Medeu. This is the women's 1,000 meters. Crowds filing in for today's events. And there you see the world and Universiad record holders. First up, Yukari Matsuzawa of Japan and Kim Hyun-jung of Korea. Kim already with a gold medal in the 500 meters here at Universiad in Almaty. She did win a silver in the 1,000 meters back at the Trentino Universiad in 2013. She's also a former Olympian, having competed at the Sochi Olympics in 2014, where she took 28th place in the 1,000 meters. And there you see Kim now on the outside lane, both skaters ahead of the leader's pace right now as they hit the bell lap. Her coach urging her on. And as you can see, still both of them well ahead of that leader's pace. Kim will cross first in a time of 1 minute, 19.19 seconds. That would be the official clocking for her. Next up, Ryo Yamada of Japan and Alexandra Kachurkina of Russia. There you see Yamada. Kachurkina on the inside, already has a gold here in Almaty, the 1500 meter gold, as well as a silver from the 500 meters. Back in late December in Coloma, Russia, she set her personal best of 1 minute 17.39 seconds. Right now on the inside lane, she and Yamada more or less neck and neck as they come up to the bell lap. Kachurkina, a big skater, a bit of an upright style, but you can see her there holding that left arm tucked in. But now has pulled ahead of Yamada and still ahead too of that leader's pace. And she will move into first just ahead of Kim Hyun-jung. Time of 1 minute 19.1 seconds for the Russian. And she's in a good spot to get her third medal of the games. There you see Yekaterina Aidova of Kazakhstan and Xia Yuning of China. For Aidova, she has a bronze from the 1500 meters here in Almaty. She studies in Karaganda here in Kazakhstan. Right now, she's well ahead of the Chinese competitor as Xia drops off the pace. And for Aidova, she heads into the bell lap ahead of the time laid down by Kachurkina. But she begins to labor, as you can see there, her coach really urging her on, knowing she's in a good spot for gold. But down the final straight, she labors mightily and will not catch the time of Kachurkina. Aidova in third spot. She will win a medal. Her second bronze here in Almaty. A really good start, but she laid everything on the line early and just didn't have enough to finish. There you see Kachurkina in the gold medal position, Kim in second with her second silver from this 1,000 meters at a Universiad. And Yekaterina Aidova on home soil wins the bronze in the women's 1,000 meters. On a cloudy, overcast day at the Alatau Cross Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex, it's the mixed team sprint in cross country skiing. You can see the snow falling here just outside of Almaty. So both men and women competing with multiple exchanges between each lap. And there we are underway. As we go along through the highlights here, you'll notice bib number 2, Kazakhstan 1, Anna Shevchenko and Olash Kleeman. Bib 16, that's France 2, with Céline Chopard-Lallier and Louis Schwartz. Bib number 1, that's France 1, with Bué and Guiguignet. And then bib 19, that would be Maria Davidenkova and Vladimir Frolov. And then bib 5, Russia 2, that is the team of Glavitsik and Vichujinin. France 1 in front right now, followed up by Kazakhstan 2 and Russia 2. Just a beautiful setting here. The snow has eased up as the race has gone on. And there you see Davidenkova of Russia. She will now hand off to Frolov in the lead with Kazakhstan 1 about a second back. And there is Frolov. And they'll come back in here for the fourth exchange. It is now Russia 2 in front. So they will hand off, and then followed by Russia 1. Davidenkova right behind, and then in bib 2, that is Shevchenko, who then overtakes all skiers with a really good push here on this lap. Shevchenko with 2 bronze already here at Universiad in the 5-kilometer pursuit and the 5-kilometer individual classic. So she's looking to add to her medal haul and starting to build a bit of a lead here over the Russian Davidenkova. Here now at the fifth exchange. Kazakhstan with a 3.5-second lead over Russia 1. France 2 in behind them. So the race right now might be for silver and bronze if Olash Kleeman, who finished fourth in the men's sprint classic, if he can have a good lap here to push off the Russians and the French. They continue to work up some of these grueling hills. And now we enter the finish area, and that lead has grown. There you see the battle for silver and bronze. That'll be Schwartz of France and Frolov of Russia comfortably with the gold medal. Kleeman and Shevchenko of Kazakhstan. And Schwartz, along with his teammate Lallier, will hold off to win the silver medal. Davidenkova and Frolov of Russia 1 will win the bronze. And there you see Shevchenko and Kleeman winning by just over 5 seconds. So it's Kazakhstan 1, France 2, Russia 1 in the mixed team sprint. From the Shymbalak Ski Resort outside of Almaty, Kazakhstan. This is the men's giant slalom. Clear day here so far. This week it's been up and down with weather, but nice conditions here for this first run of the men's GS. This is Giulio Bosca of Italy. He was 9th in the Super G combined, but did not finish in the slalom combined here earlier in the week. Trying to catch Piasek of Russia, and he'll do it. 15 100ths ahead. He moves into top spot. Now we go to Joel Mueller of Switzerland. He was 13th in the GS back at Granada in 2015. Bosca with the time to beat. And Mueller comes down and does beat it. 35-100ths ahead. So Mueller now in top spot. Next up, another Swiss skier. This is Cedric Noje. Third Universiade for Noje. He was 25th in the giant slalom at Granada and 17th in Italy at Trentino in 2013. So his countryman with a time to beat of 104.60 seconds. And Noje comes in about a half second back. So there you have the standings after the first run. Mueller on top, Bosca, then Noje. But as we get ready for the second run, you can see there the fog rolls in. So different conditions here for this second run as the athletes prepare, visualizing where they're heading down the course. And we'll start off with Noje. You can see visibility much more difficult now on this second run. Noje trying to catch Gualazzi of Italy. 7 one-hundredths ahead at that interval. It's caught up right a little bit there, but quickly back down. Skiing well around these final gates, and there's the time of Gualazzi to beat. And Noje will move into first place, 63 one-hundredths ahead of the Italian. Now here's another Italian, this is Bosca. He was second following the opening run. That heavy fog you see from that vantage point, and as they come into the lower part of the course, it's very difficult as viewers even to see back up the mountain. There's the time of Noje at the next interval. And Bosca skiing very well here, 43 one-hundredths a set ahead of the Swiss skier. Turning very well around the gates, and he'll cross. Giulio Bosca won a silver back in Granada in the Super Combined, and a silver in the Giant Slalom in Trentino, and he's in good medal position here in Almaty. Now Joel Mueller, our leader after the first run. He does have a couple first place finishes in FIS races in Switzerland so far this year. And there's the interval time for Bosca, 12 one-hundredths ahead. So Mueller still on pace for gold. Can he hold it in the bottom half of the course? Clips that gate. Might cost him a little bit of time. We'll see. Here is Mueller to the line. No, Bosca holds on. Giulio Bosca will win the gold medal in a time of 2 minutes, 12.77 seconds. Mueller, 22 one-hundredths back. Cedric Noje, also of Switzerland, 62 one-hundredths back. And there you see Bosca, much to the delight of Italian supporters. He is on top of the podium. Joel Mueller, silver, and Cedric Noje, bronze in the men's giant slalom.